Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bill Bronson is here. Tom the G. This is the third week now. Jumpin' Jack Bass is fishing for the Connecticut title.
This is the week, Bronson. I can feel it. Jumpin' Jack Bass has assured me.
This is all this guy does is fish? He's never going to get that Connecticut title.
Bronson, I'm telling you, this is the week he located it. He tracked it down. No fish finder. Au natural.
All right, well, we got tag team action here. This should be very interesting. We have, let's see, it's a six-man, four-quarters match. Everyone, everybody's got to tag anybody they want. We've got the Children of the Korn, Dan the Man, the Dark Lord, Top 10 Kid, and one half of the tag team champions, Fury. Only way to win the match is to be the last solo man. Anybody can pin anyone. It's elimination style. Should be interesting.
Tony.
You know, the Dark Lord isn't so dark anymore. Do you notice that, Bronson?
No, he totally doesn't wear his masks anymore.
He's kind of like the Undertaker. He just kind of gave up on his little gimmick there. He's just the Dark Lord.
Dan the Man drops an elbow down. And uh-oh. Somebody's coming out. And it's the Cowboy. Cowboy Tony Black is making his way to the ring.
Why the heck is he coming out here?
With his ranch hand. Meanwhile, Dan the Man's got Colossal Kevin in a powerbomb.
Wow. What a maneuver.
Here's a ranch hand with a clothesline around his neck. Two count. Three! He got a three count.
Hey, who just gave him the microphone?
Is that the NPWA is not allowing me to be in this match. You got something looks like one of my cows down the ranch. Another one looks like my best hog.
Yeah, go step in a pile of cow dust.
They got this little bad thing.
The Dark Lord with
right
a few
here.
Choice
looks
words.
I think I must have done his old lady.
Come out here, Dan.
But son of a, you know what, in this match, I don't know what.
Well, we've got Tony Black's a little upset.
Typical center ring boy, gotta have weapons. It's like that piece
I think Tony Black wants to be in this match.
Well, he's not in this match. He should get out of the way of the camera. I'm trying to watch what's going on here.
I leave when I want to leave. Come on, boy.
Here goes Dan the Man.
Come on, boy.
These two have some sort of a rivalry that's been built up.
Come on, boy.
Catch him. I can't believe he didn't catch it. That was
watch out for the ranch hand.
Hang on.
Bronson, that was a mistake on Dan the Man's part. Who's under the mask?
Hold off.
The ranch hand. Now they're both beating on Dan the Man. There's a match going on here.
Well, I think, like I said, Bronson, that was a mistake on Dan the Man's part. He, in fact, eliminated himself from this match. I don't think he's going to be able to get up. He fell into a ploy, a trap, if you will, by Cowboy Black and the ranch hand, and he paid for it, and he probably cost himself a shot at winning this elimination match. And there was a shot.
I think,
tag anybody.
I don't know, Dan the Man's still around in this match or what?
I don't think so, Bronson. I think he's out of there. Okay. I think he's hurt. He made a mistake by leaving the ring and he paid for it.
Dan the Man is being eliminated by the counter.
There you go, Bronson. I called it.
What? Oh, I guess so.
What?
Hey, there he comes. Uh-oh. Dan the Man's on fire here.
Now, Bronson, this is wrong. He's been eliminated, Bronson.
Stunner on Monster Mike. Stunner on
now, what's he doing? He ruined the match. He can't possibly stun the Dark Lord.
I don't know.
The guy's too fat.
Uh-oh. Referee shirt.
He got him.
Referee shirt.
Ouch. He's shaking it off, though.
Wow.
I think he's walking around on rubber legs. Match is still going on here. We have two men eliminated. There's four left. And now we got Top 10 Kid taking on the gigantic Dark Lord. Fans of main event today, in case you forgot from last week, the Bad Boy World Championship match against the champion Hollywood. Should be interesting to see if the Bad Boy could finally
What's this jabroni doing in the ring? Do you see who we just got for a replacement referee?
We got a new referee because the old referee was stunned. We keep going at the flow here in the NPWA. We don't stop for nothing.
Wow, and a shot by Fury. And a shot back again.
Now Fury's in there. One half, believe it or not, of the tag team champions. We haven't seen him and his partner together, and I don't know how long.
You know, I don't know what happened to the tag team titles, Bronson. When I held the tag team titles by myself, it had a little class. It meant something.
Wow. Well, I think that it's about time that we give them, I don't know, if they don't get together anytime soon, then we got to just, like, strip
them. Toss them in the river, and Jumpin' Jack Mass will catch the tag team titles. That's what you got to do.
Can't even catch the Connecticut title.
Oh, we'll see. Tonight. Tonight is the night, Bronson. I guarantee it.
He's still fishing. He's on a mission to go fishing.
That's right.
Well, we'll see about that. We'll keep checking it out. We do have, like, a satellite.
We have a live satellite feed
again. I don't know. It's pretty.
We have a cameraman.
Movie.
I personally selected the cameraman to go out there and follow Jumpin' Jack Mass's every whim. The cameraman has a link to my microphone, and I'm directing the man on the shots. I'm personally calling this. You can call it GTV, if you will. If you will.
GTV. Are you behind the GTV I've been seeing on television in the last 5-6 months? They won't tell us who it is. I think that's because it could be you.
It could be, Bronson. I'm not at liberty to say. That's all I'll say.
It's you. It's got to be. I don't know. Why
who else is the G? But I'm not at liberty to say.
Why don't you bring that GTV here, and we'll take a look at some, I don't know, we can take a look at some horrible things, like, well, stuff we can't show on public access, I would assume, but you should bring your own GTV here. I don't believe you're a GTV man. Prove it.
Bronson, don't ever back me into a corner, Bronson. I'll slap the taste out of your mouth. I'll slap those silly glasses off of your silly smirk on your face there.
Fury with a power body slam on the Dark Lord and drops the leg down. I really wish that Fury and his partner Rage would get together and maybe there's some animosity. They've each had problems in the past where they both left at different times.
A lot of personal problems.
It's been about 4 months now since they've teamed.
Is there some sort of time limit on defending the belts? I mean, I guess there isn't anymore. Well, anything goes in the NPWA, Bronson.
We'll find out maybe more on that next week. Maybe we'll have Rage come back, because I'm going to try. I've been calling his house. I haven't been able to get through to anybody. I don't know if he's left the country. I don't know what's going on, but if he don't show up next week, we're going to strip one of the titles, I think.
Whoa! Three count and Fury, speaking of.
This is
eliminated.
It.
Whoa, top 10 kid.
This is it. Last two members of the match here. This is a big, big disadvantage for the top 10 kid being a small guy.
Well, it doesn't look like it. He's got the Dark Lord on his back. If he keeps this up, he could possibly win this match. He's a house of fire. He's a little wiry bastard.
Well, he is wiry.
Oh, wow, and he missed.
I think he took his legs out.
Man, the Dark Lord, very methodical. You know, he doesn't know how to handle this top 10 kid.
We can hear you.
Oh, he missed. Dark Lord.
He talked out loud.
He went down, but top 10 wasn't home. Now where's he going? Top 10 up to the top.
Well, we've seen this before. He goes up high and he flies.
How far he's got to go?
Oh, he connected, Bronson. 2, 3, that's it, and the top 10 kid wins the match. Wow.
Unbelievable.
Talk about David beating Goliath.
Top 10 kid with a big splash victory. The survivor of the 4-quarter, 6-man elimination style match.
Incredible. How the hell did he do it?
By pitting the Dark Lord. He's all excited. One of his biggest matches.
This has got to be his biggest. A little trash talking.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, all right. I think he's got it. This could be it.
Something's going on here.
We're in live.
Uh-oh. What? He don't got nothing. Maybe he's got a nice perch. Maybe a sunfish. Perhaps a catfish, even, or a carp.
Got to get a handle down there. He's got to get a handle on it.
That's real fish. All right, that's enough. Let's get out of
he's
this.
He's got something. He's got all of a sudden.
Cameraman cut. Come on. We leave this guy on.
Wait a minute, don't cut now. I think he's got it.
We'll go back if he has anything. He's just rolling around.
Here it comes.
Oh, yeah.
Whatever.
It must be far out. Must be pretty far out.
I don't know. Wait a second. Our director's just telling us that he does have something. Wait a minute. Let's go back before we go to our title match.
Well, what do you know?
Wait a minute.
Hey, Bronson!
What do you know?
Oh, my God.
I told you. Did I tell you, Bronson?
You're kidding.
That's someday efficient.
Well, how about it?
This is impossible.
I told you, never doubt me, Bronson. We're looking at a new Connecticut State champion right there. And he caught the belt. He is the new Connecticut champion. I knew it was going to happen.
Well, the way I think of it is, I just caught rightfully mine in the first place.
Oh, come on.
Wow.
There's no...
That's all I got to say about that.
No way.
How do you like that? No way. Check it out. There's your champion. Got to celebrate.
I've seen it all now. Who says anything can't happen in the NPWA?
We just witnessed the crowning of a new Connecticut champion. And speaking of champions, there's the world champion of the NPWA.
That belt hasn't gone in no river. But if it does, I'm going to sue them for all their work.
Bronson, I hope you got a good team of lawyers. That's all I got to say. Or you better plead insanity.
The champion, Hollywood. Looks like the PGA Tour was around his neighborhood.
Could be kissing that belt goodbye, Bronson.
But a bad boy. He tipped the scale today at 450 pounds, I believe.
Is that all? Did he lose weight?
Getting to the point now where I don't know if he's going to be able to manage himself to stand up.
I think the mayor may have to step in and ban the bad boy from competing in Middletown or anywhere in the surrounding colonies.
Oh, I don't know. I keep getting flashbacks of that Jerry Springer show, and I'm wondering if it's ever going to happen with a bad boy.
The bad boy gets stuck in his own house?
Oh, he gets sawed out of there. I don't know. Yeah, it could happen. Bad boy now with a knee to the gut of the champion.
The belly willy, if you will, Bronson.
The triple toe is a major force with Sonny D, who's out somewhere, drunk somewhere probably. And bad boy to carrying a champion at one time, two times actually.
Whoa, what do you call that, Bronson?
And now, this is unbelievable that these guys are going at it.
Oh. Well, there's all that power, all the rage built up in Hollywood. I don't think he was too happy to be affiliated with the bad boy and Sonny D in the first place. I think he just wanted a couple of lackeys to boss around.
I'm just in shock that we're looking at the world champion.
Well,
and then we just saw the Connecticut championship belt that the bad boy threw in that river a couple months ago from the bounty hunter.
Bronson, believe it, you saw it from the Shockmaster himself, Jumpin' Jack Bass. Oh. He proved that he could go out and he could find the Connecticut title. He caught it. He tracked it down. He reeled it in. He caught the big fish. He was on a mission to go fishing for the Connecticut title, and he got it. He won. He pinned the belt 1-2-3.
Is he planning on ever returning to the NPWA to ever defend that championship or what?
I don't know.
He's never going to defend it anyways. It'll be taken right away from him as soon as our team of lawyers get out after him. That's not rightfully his, you know.
What are you talking about? It was disposed of. It was thrown away like an old dirty shoe.
We'll have to go to court and see who wins.
I don't think you want to fight Jumpin' Jack Bass in court. My lawyers are from Australia.
Our official today is a great competitor of the past. You know something about his collegiate. He's Mr. Ed Penunsky, medalist.
He's our
official today for this world championship match.
One of the legendary amateur wrestlers, won many, many titles. He's a great competitor in the ring. taught me a few things. Before my big matches with Sonny D, I always have to go and train with the legendary Ed P. Mr. P, we call him. Mr. Perfect, if you will. Big
clothesline.
Ouch.
And that man, by the way, that referee is out there saving lives, people. And this
could be it, but it wasn't. I think the champion, after that clothesline, has pinched a nerve in his neck. He has not let go of his back of his neck. I think he's in some pain here. Inadvertent injury here.
What do you say, Hollywood? Want to give it up?
That look on his face does not look too happy. And Ed Penunsky right in there to see if he's going to give it up.
They get it right. They call him the Great Penunsky.
Champion definitely favoring a neck injury here of some sorts. But he'll fight and continue on. The bad boy will continue. Yeah. It's going to be a war here.
It's been a war, Brownson.
Oh, maybe the referee ought to stop this. It seems like the champion, one pile driver away from maybe losing the championship. Never seen the champion so injured. Oh, my goodness. Boom. Drops him across the knee, the bad boy on top. Two, three. Whoa. He's got the rope.
Hand on the rope. Saved the world title for Hollywood.
This is probably the biggest heavyweight match we've ever had here at the NPWA.
These are two legitimate heavyweights, super heavyweights possibly, with the bad boy in there. The man is nearly a ton, folks, of the bad boy. I heard the other day that the Hong Kong buffet had to close down. They had to throw him out. He ate him out.
Oh. Bad boy should be working on the neck instead of the legs, because the neck is where the injury is.
Oh, this could be it.
Sloppy cover.
Sloppy Joe style, if you will.
Champion's in a lot of trouble. He's having problems getting up.
He's still in there. Well, the bad boy's having problems motivating himself to finish this match.
Where's Sonny D?
Who cares where Sonny D is? The guy's a bum.
You wouldn't believe this, but he's still courting around the trailer park looking for some trash. And the other day I saw him sleeping outside the NPWA arena early in the morning when I came to work. He was out there.
You know, I saw him
passed out.
I saw him fishing in the dumpster behind McDonald's looking for a bottle or something to eat.
Something's got to be done. He can't be loitering around here. I don't even think he has a home anymore.
I think I seen him sleeping in NPWA arena. You better...
I
get
did.
Security.
Well, I saw him sleeping right in front of the office building doors. Oh, big chair to the head.
Well, the Great Penunsky is allowing anything. He knows the rules in NPWA arena. He's not going to stop this for any old reason.
The Great Penunsky, that's what makes him so great, I guess, huh? One, two, and... Well, if he allows that, he'll allow anything.
He knows the rules. We went to the same school to learn how to referee.
Two, and... This was Hot Body Brown's mission to defeat all members of the Triple Terry. Went after Sonny D. Then he fought the bad boy, and Hollywood cost Hot Body Brown that matchup. Bad boy became the number one contender. Hot Body Brown was powerbombed through a table and put out for, well, we still haven't seen him in about 3 weeks now. Body slam!
Yeah, like,
wow, almost. Almost.
Couldn't quite get him up all the way. I think he might have hurt his neck.
$10,000 like Big John Studd challenge if you can body slam the bad boy.
That's like slamming King Kong Bundy.
And as I was saying, we haven't seen Hot Body Brown, and now the bad boy has stepped in and said, look, I am the man that should be the champion.
Oh, yeah.
They both fired Sonny D on the same day, and they're both going for their own world title matches, and who's going to win, we'll find out later. After that, I don't know who the number one contender will be.
Well, obviously, it should be the Connecticut champion. It should be Jumpin' Jack Bass. He's the next in line. He's the Connecticut champion. He's honestly, get your stuff together. Get on the horn. Do what you got to do. Sign what you got to sign. And get Jumpin' Jack Bass in that ring with a world title shot.
He's been
do the right thing.
He's been inactive since the third week of April when fishing season began.
Give him what he wants, Bronson.
The season's almost over, but he'll probably go hunting now like he usually does in the fall.
He's already been hunting.
Well, how come he hasn't given me no venison steaks and venison chilies?
Who the heck are you, Bronson? Why do you deserve anything? He saves that for the class people like myself, like Hot Body Brown, who deserves right now at this very moment to be having this title shot to be the NPWA world champion.
Well, Hot Body Brown. Hot Body Brown is definitely, you know he's watching this match from somewhere. You just don't know where it is.
Probably from Florida, one of his many homes around the world. Via satellite.
He could be in line. And just because he lost to the Bad Boy via fluke, because of Hollywood's interference, he could still be at some point in time the next heavyweight title contender for the championship. And he's held that belt 2 times already.
Bronson, what do you tell? He's held it 15 times. That's a record.
Well, it's only been twice. Never 15. Hollywood's in a lot of trouble, but...
Are you calling me a liar, Bronson?
I don't know. We'll have to look up in the record books. How would I know? I only began this NPWA.
That's what I wanted to hear.
Oh, my goodness. He took his legs all the way out from him. Landed on his neck again. Jimmy is going to be in a neck brace before you know it.
Well, Hot Body Brown or Jumpin' Jack Bass could be facing the Bad Boy. He may very well win this match. He's got the champion down. He's got him hurt.
He's up again, though. Bad Boy just doing the same thing over and over again, but it's working.
Slow and methodical.
Uh-oh.
Now he's got the belt. Well, he didn't win it yet.
Time to eat. Oh, no, not yet. I don't know.
He's working on the hamstring.
Well, I don't know. Bad Boy gonna bring him into the middle here. You know what he wants to set him up for? Working on the legs all this match. It's only for one thing and one thing only. The Texas roast beef that he uses.
Look at that shot.
Oh, jeez.
What a shot.
Come on.
Cameraman's a joker, I think. What's he saying
that
right here?
That explains the length of this match.
What's he saying? Chop the head off the duck. I'm ready to eat it.
I think he was saying.
Uh-oh.
Wait a second. I think he is going for the Texas roast beef.
There it is. Oh, my God.
Perhaps. Got it. Sunk in. Turns him over.
Oh, no.
There's no way the champ's going to get out of it.
He's too close to the rope.
He's
going to
get the rope, I think. The champion is close to the rope. He should break it up. And wait, what the heck?
What is going on? Holy cow. What just happened?
Well, that's Hot Body Brown. Where'd he come from?
He just came out from underneath the ring.
I seen it all now. Between that and Jumpin' Jack Bass.
And he's throwing Hollywood on the Bad Boy. And the great Penutsky just made a 3 count.
Wow.
Brownson. What a show. What just happened this week? We've seen it all this week. And there it is. Hot Body Brown. Saving the title for Hollywood. But why? I wonder.
Does he like the Bad Boy that much?
He hates that fat.
Does he want Hollywood that bad?
The match was back. Bad Boy had to come out here and carry the two guys to have a big maturity to get blown out of.
Did you get that, Bronson?
No.
All the things you guys have done to me. Everything
he's talking over two guys that are both out. I think the Bad Boy knows what happened.
Oh, I think he's going to take the lovely Lady Lee into bondage or something.
It always was, it always will be, and you just have one borrowing it right now. I don't believe that you could be here representing the NPWA like this.
Great Penutsky's looking on.
I think he truly believes what Hot Body Brown is saying.
He let him come up from the bottom of the ring with a bat.
Could this be a conspiracy?
The triple terror, I'd say.
I know.
Wow, the great Penutsky.
As much of a loser as these guys, okay?
But oh, he just insulted right Lady Leah.
What is she doing? It's no place for one. Whoa!
Look out! What's going on?
Trying to choke. Oh, wait.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh. Well, she deserved it.
He didn't do nothing. I don't think Hollywood even knows what happened.
Well, she's clumsy. That's all I got to say. She fell on her way in. I mean, she jumped on his back and then she fell off. Wow, is right. The wow counter has got to be up to about 40.
And Hollywood sees her down, and I don't think he knows how this happened.
Bad boy's out.
All I know is
that's unfortunate. Hollywood is still the champion. As is Jumpin' Jack Bass is the Connecticut champion. Wow, we've had a great show.
This is the most unusual show I've ever seen.
Came out from under the ring.
Did he dig under there during the day and throw a piece of... I don't know how he did
it. There must be a secret tunnel under there.
That was the final straw.
Uh-oh. What's he talking about?
You've done some low things in your past.
Hot Body Brown wasn't hated before. He's really hated now by Hollywood.
Well, Hollywood mostly hates him. Mostly.
On a poor, defenseless woman. That, you can't get any lower than that. So, Hot Body Brown?
I think Hollywood's a little punch drunk. I think it's a little too soon to be talking on the mic after he's just been beaten down.
Yes, that's right, ladies and gentlemen. The heavyweight champion.
Bad boy's out.
Is challenging.
I think... The Hollywood's challenging Hot Body?
I've never heard of such a thing. A champion challenging the challenger.
You'll be all right. The Hot Body Brown, that's it.
And Lady Lee is out.
I've had it up to here with you.
She must have hit her head on one of those rocks underneath the NPWA ring.
That's about enough.
Well, you know what? We'll take a look at the replay here and see if we can sort out as exactly what happened.
Look at the fat boy raising his fat arm.
I don't think he can get up. I think that we should seriously see a clinic for the bad boy.
We got to rent a crane. Bronson, you're going to be set back a few $100 because you got to get a crane and a tow truck to get his fat bum out of there. Beach bum. Look at him.
Oh, unbelievable. Poor Lady Leah.
Get her out of here.
Poor Lady.
Get her out of here. Speed it up, Speedy. Let's get back.
There's gonna be,
look at her,
payback time. Here's the replay. Look at this, he popped right out of the bottom.
Where did he come from?
He was there the whole match?
I guess so.
I never saw him come out during the match.
How did they walk all over? You know, that's the ancient art of enziguri or something like that. Where you can, your camouflage, you can hide out there. And people can walk on you, they can throw darts at you. He did it. And that was the end of the match.
And look at that, the champion never even saw this. What? I think he thinks that Hot Body Brown physically assaulted Lady Leah, which isn't the case.
And it was the other way around. She tried to physically harm Hot Body Brown, and he did the right thing like a man. He just said, forget about her.
That's probably why, forget about her. That's probably why Hollywood is so angry. Here's what we saw earlier today.
Look at that.
Do you
believe it, Bronson?
I don't know.
So
he's in celebration, and the cameraman's telling us that he's celebrating for you, Tampa G.
I hope so. There it is.
He's got something for you, he says.
Something for me?
Tampa G, you need a beer?
Yeah. Hell yeah!
What? He said he's going to get there.
I think he's got a big one.
No, he doesn't.
I think he's got a big one. I think he's got a beer.
This is one of the last times I'm ever going to go. I can't be this shocked again next week.
What? Yeah! That's my man!
That's a good beer.
Oh, all right. I've gone sick. Hey, I'll take that. That's for the camera guy. Come on.
That's good fish.
Nice treat.
Yeah, the new Connecticut champion
is. Now you gotta win in the ring, you slob.
That's a celebration.
Later, folks.
Congratulations, Jumpin' Jack Bass.